Welcome back to Jewelry for Rhino Design Tutorials. Today I'm going to use several examples to explain common uses of the Rails Sweep 4 tool and teach you how to design this ribbon pendant with the rail tool. For now, let's learn how the tool works. Sweep 4 requires 4 rail curves, which I prepared ahead of time. Switch to Sweep 4. There are 2 modes here. Let's learn the one on the right first. Take a screenshot and put it here for reference. Select the option on the right. Here we need to select the rail curves in numerical order. 1, 2, 3, 4. Select the profile. The surface generated in this selection mode has 4 curves that we can modify to directly control its undulations and slopes, which Sweep 3 cannot do. We can move curves or control points to adjust parts of the surface. For example, the slope of this position can be larger. Raise it a bit. Adjusting the rise and fall of the pendant in this way is much more controllable. No need to use cage edit. It's very simple. If you want to add detail to the surface of the ribbon, you can modify this profile directly. This creates a different style of design. Next example. These are the rail curves for a bee pendant. The direction of the rails is different from the first example. The order of selection is left, right, up, and down. Take a screenshot for reference. Select the rail curves according to the order of the reference image. Selecting the profile. This rail mode is sometimes used for insect modeling in this way. It is somewhat similar to Sweep 3, but with one more direction to control than Sweep 3. We can adjust the curvature of the bottom separately. It's very convenient. For the left and right curves, we can adjust its width. Like this. All other parts can also be generated using the rail tool. More than 80% of the styles we encounter in our daily design work can be created using the rail tool. So the skillful use of the rail tool can greatly improve the efficiency of our design modeling. For example, we can use Sweep 2 for the wings. For the end, you can use Make Uniform to smooth it. Remember to remove the control points inside the body. For the head tentacle, just use JFR pipe to generate it. And add a sphere to it. That's it for this example. Next, start learning today's design case. Now I'm going to show you how easy it is to make this ribbon loop pendant with Sweep 4. Place the image in the upper left corner. Select a layer and lock it. First step is to draw the contour of the pendant using the Polygon Mirror Curve. Quantity is 10. I recommend starting out by drawing the bulge in the center. When finished, rotate the pendant by 90 degrees. Set the size of the pendant with the Edit Box tool. Open the Z-axis and X-axis directions at the same time. Change the size to 15. Duplicate the contour line and scale it down. Right-click on the Polygon Mirror Curve to edit the curve. Reverse the modification, but with a weaker curvature than the outer curve. That's pretty much it. The top and bottom rail curves are done. Now we need to make the left and right rail curves. Duplicate this curve. Right-click on it to edit it. Modify it to be close to a circle. The reason for duplicating the curves is that we have to make sure that all 4 curves have the same number of control points. Here's the point. Now I'm going to switch to top view. Turn on orthogonal. we can move the control points up and down to make the curvature of the curve. The curve on the left is ready. Horizontal mirror. Enhance the wave effect. At this point, the pendant is 70% complete. The next step is to draw out the profile, still using the polygon mirror curve. Draw a flower outline. Open the control points. Delete the bottom control point. Now the profile is ready. Open the rail tool. Switch to sweep 4. Select the first option, which is more commonly used. Select left, right, top, bottom. Profile. The basic shape is ready. Edit the curves and adjust the shape of the surface. Just fine-tune it. Now rotate the pendant by 90 degrees. Don't select this curve. It has a record history. Rotate it 90 degrees. Then make the knot in the center of the ribbon. Switch to the ghosted display. Use the vertical mirror curve to draw the rail curve. Isolate. I'm going to use rail revolve to create it. Draw an open profile. Remember, it must be open. Select rail revolve. Select the center position. Change this to rail center. Scale it up a little bit. Then open up the control points and adjust the curvature. The difference in height on the inside can be smaller. Use polar array to make 10 copies. The shape of the pendant is now ready. Next, add a loop clasp to the pendant. Find the straight clasp in the database. There are a lot of clasp models in the database, so feel free to choose the one you like when practicing. Adjust the size and it's almost ready. Rail tool here to explain the end. I hope you can skillfully master this tool. It is really very useful. At this point, the pendant is complete. Thanks for watching this far. If this video was helpful to you, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to us. See you next time.